beloved, we are gathered together in the sight of God to celebrate the beginning of a marriage. To participate with Bill and Tammy in the new direction that their lives together are taking. And we, by our presence here, are saying to them, this is important. We are pleased to stand with you and rejoice with you. Tammy and Bill, by your coming together on this day, you are saying to each other and to the world, we live together because we choose to, and even if this legal tie does not exist, we still choose to live together. So I charge you both, as you stand in the presence of God and this company, to understand anew your commitment to each other. Into this sacred covenant, these two persons now desire to enter. Let us therefore invoke the blessing of God on the union now performed. Let us pray. Almighty and most merciful God, we, your unworthy children, praise you for all the bounties of your providence and for all the gifts of your grace. We thank you especially for the institution of marriage which you have ordained to God to hallow and to perfect the gift of love. Thank you for the joy which these your servants find in each other and for the love and trust in which they enter this holy covenant. And since without your help we cannot do anything as we are, we pray you to enrich your servants with your grace. They may enter into their marriage as in your sight and truly keep their vows. We pray in the name of him who taught all of us to pray together saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Bill, will you have this woman to be your wife and to be faithful to her alone? Tammy, will you have this man to be your husband and to be faithful to him alone?
But then I heard some notes with mine, and magically the songs combined. I turned around and saw you standing there. There's magic in the melody that your sweet love has given. I'd like to song in your heart too. And we will be a family and sing our songs in harmony. The songs of love that last a lifetime through. Oh, the songs of love. Deftly as a downy dove, you lifted me on wings of love and carried me above the world's confusion. Now my life has been transformed, my empty heart. There's magic in the melody that your sweet love has given me. I'd like to place a song in your heart too. And we will be a family and sing our songs in harmony. The songs of love. Oh, the songs of love that last.
word of God from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 13, verses 1 through 8. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver my body to be burned but have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. Bill and Tammy, your relationship to each other has been and will hopefully continue to be like two separate trees that were transplanted so closely together that the roots and the branches have become intertwined, and the trunks themselves have become as being grafted to one another. And as the rains fall on the soil and the sun shines on the leaves and the wind blows on the branches, the two trees will sometimes be competing and sometimes sharing, sometimes pushing against each other and sometimes supporting each other. And the places where the two trees keep rubbing against each other occasionally wear away the bark and become like an open wound. But then these worn places can also become places of growing together. Truly your lives will be like these trees if you are faithful to the words of the Apostle Paul in his letter to the church at Corinth, keeping in mind the essence of Christian love. Each other now, Phil and Tammy, and exchange the marriage vows to each other.
I promise to live each day with you
as if it were my last.
To be honest with you,
even though it may sometimes hurt.
Tell you everything.
All my feelings as well as my thoughts.
I promise you all the happiness capable of giving.
To let nothing keep us apart.
As long as we both want to be together.
To lend you my advice.
But not demand that you take
me. I promise to share your sorrow.
As well as your joy.
And as long as you will accept it.
I promise you all.
Tammy and Bill will now exchange the symbols of the promises that they have just made. They will exchange the rings. And the rings are symbols of the covenant promises that Bill and Tammy have made to each other. The circles are also symbols of God, without beginning or end, and with no point of weakness. The circle is a reminder of the eternal quality of God and of unending strength. Now Bill and Tammy have picked some music, some special music, for this moment. The music is from the group Atlanta that Bill will be a part of.
Get any better.
because Bill and Tammy have exchanged their promises of faithful love, and because in our presence they have exchanged symbols which make their covenant visible, therefore we now recognize before God and this company that Bill and Tammy are husband and wife in the name of God. Amen. There's somebody else, another important person that we also want to recognize.
Wedding rings are very special to us. We're going to wear them all our lives and remember how important this day is. We have something for you too. You know what's inside this invisible purse? I'll show you. This is for you. It contains a picture of the three of us that you can wear whenever you want.
I'd like to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. William Packard and Hickey.